Okay, the barking dog is put in a car with its owner. Long street. Georgia Confederate soldiers. We sleep here in obedience to law. When duty called, we came. When country called, we died. Was a bird. Tis a mailbox. No, bird house. Career Ricket. Eleventh Mississippi, Laws Brigade, Hood's Division, 2012 Monument. Duty brought them to the field, honor led them into battle, valor covered them with glory. Latin, the love of my country leads me. What's that mean, that Latin? For all you know, yeah, rice people to rob us. 104th New York, Wadsworth Guards. Duryea's Brigade, Ricketts Division, Hooker's Corps. Fought in the cornfield near this spot. Memorable morning engagement between Hooker and Stonewall Jackson. There's like some kind of drill going on in the background and the airplane overhead. Wonder if they know flying over history. Pennsylvania, 26 killed, 86 wounded, 6 missing, 118. Seventh Pennsylvania, beaching in the car church box. Location of regiment in action, 415 yards north of monument. Well, somebody walked it off to make sure. See, I'm of the opinion they should put the monuments right at that spot. It would be more interesting to, well, you know, to walk in there. But I get it that the veterans, you know, wanted people to see it. The majority of people. Silas Cosgrove, I believe he was killed at Gettysburg. Seventh Indiana, weren't they part of, who do you call this brigade? Oh yeah, this is really interesting. Wow, that is the coolest monument. Here fought the 90th Pennsylvania, Philadelphia, 1776. A hot place. Holy shit. Dude. That is incredibly badass. Look at this. What is it made of? God, when was it put here? This is the really most unique monuments I've ever seen. Pennsylvania. Line of direction of Hartstuff's brigade, September 17th. From Duryea's brigade? It's Hartstuff. Duryea is the other one. Ricketts' division, I mean? Yes, yes, I was right. Even though I know so very little. I brought all the books here, but what the fuck, you know? I got it. Jen can watch the TV while I check out the books. We'll have the whole day to spend here. And we're stationed right off the battlefield, which is amazing. I mean, even Sharpsburg is a little bit of a drive, like 5 minutes. Well, I guess this one's like 2 minutes drive, but still. I know I'm not absorbing that right now. But I'm here at Antietam, and I'm already thinking about the day at Antietam that I'm gonna have all day today. And tomorrow to Manassas, Virginia. And thence, yes, I said thence to Gettysburg. Battery B, First Maryland Light. Their position was east of the edge of the crest of the woods, 240 yards north. So these monuments represent, you know, 200 to 400 yards north up there. Not incredibly far, just like in the middle of what is now corn, but I think the cornfield started a little bit further back, if I'm to understand what I've read with some of these. USA. That's Hillary Lyon. Yards to the northeast corner of Miller's Cornfield. 92 yards to southeast corner of Miller's Cornfield. Alright, so 90 yards ahead was, that's not far. And then just 324 yards to the top end of it. So all these, most of these monuments represent positions just here, cornfield or ahead of it. Jackson's Command. Those kind of signs. I think we just read about the distance of the corn. First New Jersey Brigade. Charged the woods north of the Dunker Church when it was countermanded. Wow. Western line of the East Woods. Western line of the East Woods. Sixth Army Corps, Major General Franklin. and the trail. Cornfield Trail. Where is this part of? Yeah, not part of a larger trail. I started the morning. Oh, there still says Cornfield Trail on the side flash. I started the morning on the north edge of the north woods. By the east woods. Cornfield. A couple more markers here, and then we head back to the car. I guess this is just like people live right there. It's pretty wild. So three markers here, and I'll have hit everything on this Cornfield Avenue. Means Division 12 Corps. The house does look pretty old. So I started way up there. What I thought that was a cornfield was not, but damn. Well, the first one, okay, I got it. General Mansfield killed in the East Woods. I think that was Cornfield Avenue, and there's another sign there on the road. I gotta see what it says. And that house does look pretty cool with the flag. It just says the Cornfield Avenue on the little sign. Good luck. Streets Command. Wow. There's the sunken road. People live there, so I don't want to get stupidly intrusive. But man, that's an old ass house. Here comes somebody revving up the road. All right, I'm actually heading back because that was a full walk on the Cornfield Avenue. Man, oh man, the Shabbat's eastwards, Cornfield Avenue, so how connected to Bloody Sunken Road, Bloody Lane. Garland's Brigade. I should show a picture of that to Jimmy. 2050. Garland's Brigade. The Cornfield Avenue, it's called. Wow, the Cornfield Avenue. I'm just sinking in. There's the Cornfield Trail. 1.6 miles, so I would have come down out of that and continued on. How the heck far does it go? I didn't think about a breakfast. I mean, I'm sorry to be thinking like this here. Yeah, look, we'll figure that out. I'm sorry. 1,000 pardons to be on here, Eastwoods Cornfield, and it's just a part of the life that has to go on today. Maybe. Maybe not. It took maybe an hour of footage, I think. Still hear that drill way up ahead. Ringing out. Doesn't you know there should be a noise ordinance unless you're sounding off musket fire. It'd be badass if I could see the Dunker Church from here. But it's not very far. Over that ridge, there are undulating hills and ridges, and I see USA one. I am pointing at the cornfield. That is the cornfield. Where I was on the north side. I should have realized by when the sign said north edge of the north woods that the cornfield. I didn't know it, that the cornfield didn't go up that far. But it's more wide than it is. It's more long than it is high, tall. Hard Stuff's Brigade one. I'm gonna play. D.H. Hill, good old Daniel Harvey Hill. Is that badass one? Pennsylvania, a hot place. Do they mean like exactly this spot? Yeah, because they put it on these rocks, and I guess they remembered these rocks. Maybe this stand of trees wasn't here. Probably not. So rebel musket balls would have been flying towards us and through this direction. And also Confederate artillery would have been also. It's like a ranger. Park's not over yet. It was a ranger. It was a park ranger. I gave him a wave. I've given every car a wave. You want to go past the car and those monuments that are... This is how they appear to my eye. Actually a little bit bigger than that. But no, I gotta shrink it up, otherwise it's too wobbly on the walk. 11th Mississippi, who were devastated at Gettysburg. I remember being here with Ray and Alan, just having that feeling like we didn't have the time to get it really enough out of it, and we were just kind of going from spot to spot with a little bit of walking, and you know, never broke out a book. The Georgia Confederate Soldiers one. Be cool if like you could spot the Dunker Church down there. I don't know how, it's not that far. It's relatively not very far. Wofford's Brigade, Hood's Division. And I saw these on the way down, just reiterating with the sun popping out. Ha ha ha. It does feel nice and warmer. I spent $75. I know I hate to digress from where I'm at. In the gift shop yesterday, getting a nice, really nice Antietam coffee cup. Out of respect. And, sun is out, man. Bring on the sun. It's 30 minutes from the time I re-put it on. Hood's Division. Both of these Hood's Division. I saw these, right? Yeah. I'm not sure if I did. Well, I went straight to the Texas one. I can't imagine I would have turned south. Or west, rather. Interesting to count the steps of this morning. Cornfield. I mean, book it. Don't book it. That is the actual edge of the cornfield, or historical cornfield. And it's all trampled down eventually. I couldn't have paused that on the long one. Oh, they stepped out of the cornfield at dawn. Horrific folly. Wow. Wow. This wall, constructed by Harpers Ferry Job Corps Conservation Center, 1967. Oh, this wall and me are the same age. Both went up. We both emerged on the earth the same year, 1967. Oh, well, that was a berry. Right? I got a berry. Is he patting a berry? Yeah, there's a berry there. I think like the birds better not be. No, there's no purple bird crap. Anyhow, I'll live. Let's see what we got here. Second U.S. sharpshooters, Staunton. Oh, nothing in the back. That's New Jersey. Interesting, they're facing that direction. What the hell you call that again? Obelisk. Thank you. Is that a monument? I guess we're gonna find out. That's a tall one. Yeah, Yeah, it's that purple stuff, whatever that is. It felt like a berry. There's no way it's crap. All right, let that go. Stairs up. Interesting to find out when this one went up. Second New Jersey. General Orders. First New Jersey. Thirteenth New Jersey. And the plaque at the bottom. Erected in 1903. There you go. And then it also has the, what do you call, that shot. Dang. The Cornfield Avenue. There's a few more to hit. Just keep on going, these plaques and monuments. The Commonwealth of Massachusetts to mark these positions erected by, held by our troops, the Battle of Antietam. Yeah, Massachusetts Monument. Interesting. Almost just looked like a, I don't know, park entranceway sign. From the olden times. Purple things everywhere. Map of the battlefield. Bloody Lane, Mummers Lane. Oh wow, today's my birthday, I didn't even realize. I just saw a message from Ray pop up. And there's the visitor center, so that means there's the Dunker Church just right down there. Well, cool. I'll tell them that was on the Massachusetts Monument at Antietam when he sent me that message. All right. Oh, man, there's another one over there. Oh, big hawk. That was a hawk. I don't know if the footage... was caught on footage. Oh, there he's right there. That's him right there. Hello, Hawk. He don't care. He's not even looking at me, showing me disdain. Anyhow, this is Sedgwick, Second Army Corps. On my birthday, Hawk. It's my birthday. I didn't even realize till now. I knew it was coming up. I'll be. It's my birthday at Antietam. All right. If I go down that far, I'm sure there's going to be another one and another one and another one. That's the plaque. I got to go over there. I know what that is. That's where the famous photograph was taken. Now I know why the one monument was facing in that direction. So if it's like an hour and a half from the time, it's probably like 8:30 to me, 7:30 to her. I'm just trying to figure out if my friend is awake. People walking up the road. To Westwoods Trail. Man, this is 41 minutes in. To Cornfield Trail. So all these trails are connected, which is cool. Yeah, this is the spot. Right here. That photograph was taken. There's the hawk. There's a monument over there too. There's just so many. I'm gonna walk up this way. I can only do so much. I can't hit the whole battlefield in the morning. It's just a lot of monuments, bro. Oh, that's the road again. It's okay. It's all right. Gotta be careful of my feet and ankles here. So I'm walking along a Confederate literal line of battle here. Stark Avenue. Colonel Joseph W. Hawley. Twenty-fourth Pennsylvania. It's near the spot that the regiment, within 6 weeks after leaving home, took an active part in this great battle. Wow, within 6 weeks of leaving home, took part in this great battle. Well, damn. Erected in 1904. There's just too many, bro. There's more markers down there and down there. And I can see this one. I did see a lot, he said, trying to reassure himself. Okay, that's the monument I was on. walking on when Ray texted me. Go to that and we come back. This started out to be a much smaller walk than it became. It's not a huge walk by any stretch of the imagination. Indiana. I'll come back onto that one. See these plaques. Oh, there's a pullout here. So. Okay. There's more markers, of course, yet further. I mean, why wouldn't there be? Okay. I have to leave those. Gordon's Brigade and Ransom's Battery, 550 yards. Okay, last two. Okay, there's two more 5 feet away. And there's a pullout for them. I'm on the edge of the cornfield. See? One, two, three more. Look, there's a cannon right there. The fuck? 12th Army Corps, Goodrich's Brigade. New York is in there. Cornfield. Poffenberger Farm? It's that hawk right there. Medal of Honors, two of them given to soldiers of this battery. Which there's 34 men killed and 27 horses killed. Dawn to 7:30 a.m. Union Battery. Those are some amazing stats right there. Sheesh. All right. I know there's markers right down there, but I can't keep going and expect to get back at any reasonable time. So, I gotta walk past the dog walker. I still gotta get into the obelisk monument. Obelisk. They might yell at me for being on the grass. I was a park ranger again. I half expected to get yelled at for being on there. Morning. Okay. Well, hello there. You're getting on the footage too. Hello, baby.
She just wants to be loved by us.
Well, you have my love, okay?
All right.
You have a great day. Thank you. It's 10:20 a.m. Part of the right wing across the road. Interesting. This is Indiana. With all the big mini balls. Recognize those units. 19th Indiana that became part of the Iron Brigade, part of the Iron Brigade. That's all it says on it. It's very, very Spartan, or is that the word? Austere now. Damn it. Well, they're. I'm surprised nobody had anything to say about them. Okay. It's been a very, very cool walk down the Cornfield Avenue back up and then onto the Hagerstown Pike. And let's have a great day. Happy birthday to me. Curve there. Yeah. 54 minutes in. All right, Cornfield. Will I come back and walk up the center of you? Maybe. If anyone's entitled to stand on this wall, it's me. Joking. Visitor center right there. Dunker Church in that direction, equidistant from the top of the visitor center. Okay, I'm getting my bearings a little bit.